Okay, now that we have seen how to do registry naming and how to follow the true dependencies and so on, we are ready to learn what the instruction level parallelism or ILP is. So we will now define what it is. So the ILP really can be defined as the IPC instructions per cycle when we have a processor that can do an entire instruction in one cycle. So it doesn't need a pipeline. It can fetch, decode, execute, write result, everything in just a single cycle for one instruction. Also, the processor can do any number of instructions in the same cycle. So theoretically, it could just fetch and execute your entire program in the one cycle. But it still has to obey true dependencies. So if one instruction depends on another, then they cannot be done in the same cycle. You have to first do one and then the one that needs its result. So as you can see, ILP really is kind of what an ideal processor can do, subject only to obeying true dependencies. How do we compute the ILP for a program? Well, we first rename all the registers. So we do register renaming first, and then we pretend we execute. So what we do is we say, okay, in the first cycle, these are the instructions that don't depend on anything, so they can go. In the next cycle, we go through the same thing and so on until we run out of instructions to do, at which point we know how many cycles it is. Now, the one thing that you should remember about the ILP and that will help you realize what it is and how to do it is that ILP is a property of a program, not of any particular processor. So basically, we define the ILP to be what would this program do as far as the IPC is concerned on an ideal processor. So it has nothing to do with what kind of processor you actually run it on. It has everything to do with just the dependencies in the program. So be mindful of that because, for example, it doesn't make really sense to say something like, what's the ILP on this program on the, I don't know, Intel Core i7 processor? Because the ILP on the Intel Core i7 processor is beside the point because the ILP is really the performance of this program on an ideal processor that has nothing to do with Intel i7. Okay, so just remember that. When you're asked to produce the ILP, you should just consider the program. It doesn't matter what the processor looks like because the ILP is computed for a perfect processor anyway. In contrast, you could say that the IPC of this program on a given processor is something else, but be mindful of this. Basically, the ILP, you only need to see the program. You don't really need to know what the processor looks like.